This prickly succulent is known as Haworthiopsis glauca. Now, it used to be Haworthia, but a lot of Haworthia got put into Haworthiopsis for whatever reason. I actually can't comment on it, but maybe somebody knows and can actually comment below. But you can see that this one has a lot of sharp spines. And to my knowledge, I think Haworthiopsis glauca has a lot of different types of variations and forms. So I'm actually not even sure if this is a pure species or if this is a different type of variation. But I've actually seen these in botanical gardens where you could see that this one's kind of, falling over. That's actually pretty typical because in some of the botanic gardens that I see, they're kind of growing and they're just kind of trailing. I wouldn't say they're trailing. They're kind of like lying. They're kind of lying down on their sides. You're just kind of like taking in some of the sunlight. So this is not, you know, leaning a little bit more towards the light or not. It just happens that it gets a little maybe top heavy and starts to grow that way. So that is typical for this particular species. Now, as far as fertilizing goes, this plant is totally fine with doing a little bit more of a monthly fertilizer. And I have to say that this is, if I can remember off the top of my head, this is opposite. The growing season is actually in the winter and the non-growing season is actually in the summer. So you're going to actually want to flip the fertilizing schedule for this plant. It's actually native to the Cape provinces, so in, you know, South Africa area. So yeah, that is like one of those things that with Haworthiopsis, the fertilizing schedule is going to be reverse. Now, if you do see it actually growing, because sometimes in our indoor schedules, or if you're actually growing in a warmer climate, then there might not actually be a dormant season. Or if your winters are pretty mild, then there might not actually be a dormant season. So you just want to keep an eye out for your plant and just observe what it's doing. Observation is always the best remedy, and not just taking what I say as gospel, but using it more as a guide. So what else can I say about this plant? Full sun, likes full sun, can handle full sun. Even if you pull it back a little bit more further away, it's from the intense sunlight and you give it a little bit more of an indirect bright light, that's going to be fine for this plant. You could probably even get away with growing it in more medium light. But if you are growing this plant, I'd love to hear how you're growing it. As far as, you know, the substrate goes, you could see that I have a pretty rocky mixture here. So I have a little bit of lava stones. I have some perlite. I like to put a little bit of bonsai mix in my succulent soil sometimes too. I think it actually might, like, looks nice, but it also helps with the drainage as well. And for those of you who are always interested in where I get my planters, this is actually a vintage planter that I picked up at one of the local Brooklyn shops. So I know sometimes you can't like get the same planters that I do. Sometimes you can, but a lot of the ones that I get are vintage. So I am going to try to mention those a little bit more if I have something unique to say about them. But otherwise, pretty cool plant. Don't worry if it's hanging off to the side, looking a little limp. That's exactly how it's supposed to look. Haworthiopsis glauca. And glauca, I should say that, just means a little bit more of the coloration. If it has a little bit more of a glaucous coloration, then it has that little bit more of that like bluish, greenish look.